Hey everybody, good morning to you.
And good morning to John Denver as well. That was a little Rocky Mountain High if you're a John Denver fan, that is a fan of the late John Denver. Well, good morning y'all. It's Friday morning, everybody. It's Friday morning, Friday morning. Turn to your neighbor and say, way to go, you made it to Friday morning. Wow, we'll say way to go here in the studio. So, some news. Here's my vaccination card. I get my second one today. My second vaccination today, that's right. So I'm pretty excited. So let me remind you again to get yours today, as of, I guess just today, right? It didn't matter at what time?
Today, or maybe it was Monday, I can't remember.
I think it's today.
Awesome.
Here in Memphis, if you're 16 or above, and I'm pretty sure we don't have anybody out there who is less than 16 years old. You can get your COVID shots beginning today if you're 16 and over. Here are the dates about when you need to have your vaccinations to join me on Monday, May the 3rd in person. So your first shot has to be by the 26th, that's next week. Your second shot has to be by April 19th, so that you're 2 weeks beyond your second inoculation. That's when they say that you're vaccinated. So just to put that out there. So I'll be getting my second one today.
Excellent.
I know. I think I might have told you, I was able to get mine through the VA. It didn't matter how old you were or what health you were. If you were an honorably discharged member of the armed services, you were automatically eligible to get the shot, which I did. Okay, so beyond that, let me say thank you for your support. I don't think I introduced myself.
What?
Hey everybody, I'm still Sergeant Tony Ludlow coming at you.
Yes.
The sign behind me, do I look like a game show hostess? The sign.
Prettier than all of them too.
Aw, thank you. Prettier than the game show hostesses. If you would like to have some engagement with us, and you're maybe you've never had any engagement with us, you'll have to make the first move. It's like a junior high dance. Somebody else has to make the first move. Those junior high dances. That's all the boys on one side of the dance floor, all the girls on the other side, and then the guys thinking, okay, who's going to be brave enough to walk across over there and ask a girl to dance. That was tough.
Were you ever the first one to
me?
Get out there?
I never was the first one.
Really?
I was scared.
I'm sort of surprised.
I was a scaredy cat. Anyway, so if you would like to have some engagement with us, and we would love to have that with you, you'll have to say something first. That way people can watch and not have to feel that I'm going to start calling them out or saying things to them that might be embarrassing or something. Not that I would or anything. But, okay, so enough about that. Let's talk about today. First of all, let's do a quick accounting. We were not live on Monday. We were alive.
Thankfully.
Monday. See what I did there?
About that.
We were alive on Monday, but we were not Facebook live on Monday. So I really can't say three times this week is an A, but I can. So if it's three times this week for you, that is an A. Give yourself yeah. Three times is an A. Twice, that would be your B. That would be what I'm getting, your B. And then one time, that is a passing grade. That is a C.
We'll take it. We'll
That's
take
right.
It.
You know what C's get at Ole Miss? Dean's List.
I was going
to
say beer.
I shouldn't make jokes about Ole Miss. My son-in-law is a graduate of Ole Miss. I know it's a shameful thing to have to admit. Okay, so enough about that. Craig, if you're out there, I love you, and I'm just messing with you.
I was going to say, I got some funny info here.
Okay.
Cranky Pants said she is laminating her vaccination card because she's going to be using it for her daily Krispy Kreme donut. Because if you show,
right.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's smart.
Right. That's right. One of the comedians, I forget who it was, said that if you after you get your second inoculation, if you go to Krispy Kreme, they'll let you lie down on the icing conveyor belt and send you through the icing machine.
Oh, take a ride. Don't tempt me. Don't tempt me.
Take a ride on the icing machine. I believe I'll put that to the test. Okay.
I'd like that
enough,
myself.
Enough foolishness. We will continue our Friday routine of having about 3/5 of the workout be your usual boot camp fare of weighted exercises and body weight exercises, and then we'll have some time for stretching, additional stretching at the end. So we'll do that. I posted an article from the New York Times about really it's about the problems of excessive exercise and a particular kind of excessive exercise. Take a look at that and read that over, and you'll see that our goal has always been to try and maintain a consistency within exercise science. We are not one of the great benefits of not having a brick and mortar outfit and have some sort of a fitness franchise with some sort of fitness company of some sort is that I can do things my own way. And if exercise science gives us a new insight into something, we can pivot, we can make an alteration. For example, the push-ups, in the last few months, I've had us alter the way that we do our push-ups because exercise science has helped us out to see that there was a better way of...
Just like ice baths.
Like ice baths.
We used to recommend, and then... And nutrition is like that.
Yeah. I still recommend the ice baths, particularly for the... That's a whole nother story.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Without further ado, the star of our show and the love of my life, Ashley Ludlow, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm so happy to that.
You should see Ashley's shirt. Let me see if...
Oh, yeah.
So that might be this would be a riddle for some of you. What does that mean?
And I'm wearing this in honor of my good friend, Bethany Smith.
And my shirt is easy to figure out.
Yes.
When are you going to start being excellent to me?
I'm pinching.
Oh, hey. Don't be pinching the...
I'm good.
Okay. Without further ado and without further foolishness, let's get started, shall we?
Ah, yes.
Okay.
Turn on my...
Let me take one quick look. If you want some engagement with us, you'll have to say hello. Otherwise, we are...
Hold on. I need to turn it on. I think I had an alarm set on my phone. I apologize. Uh-oh. We don't want that going on.
No, off. No,
I
no.
Make your morning. Okay.
Okay. We're ready to go then.
I'm ready.
All right. Here we go. Side straddle hops for 10. Ready. Exercise. 1, 2, 3.
1.
1, 2, 3.
2.
1, 2, 3.
3.
1, 2, 3.
4.
1, 2, 3.
5.
1, 2, 3.
6.
1, 2, 3.
7.
1, 2, 3.
8.
1, 2, 3.
9.
1, 2, 3. Okay. We're going to start. Well, that's a workout, everybody. We're done. Turn to your neighbor and say, way to go, good neighbor. No, it's time to start doing you're going to need your chair. I should have told you that earlier. So get a chair or move your phone or computer, whatever device you're using to watch this morning. So you can use the chair. We're going to do wide stance, sumo squats, double squat, double press with the chair. We won't be doing as many as we might otherwise without the chair. What the benefit of the chair is that you'll get a tactile, and I keep saying tactile response, meaning that you know, you get a, I don't want to say sensation either about your booty, but you will, and then tactile response doesn't sound right either. What I'm trying to say is, you will know that you've gone all the way down because your booty will make contact with the chair. You will feel that, and that is my point. Okay, all right, here we go. Wide stance, sumo squats, double squat, double press with the chair. Ready, exercise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2.
1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7.
3.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
4.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
5.
1, 2, 3, 4,
five, six, seven.
Six.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Seven.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Eight.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Nine.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go. You can put that down. All right. Side straddle hops. You'll still need your chair.
Okay.
Side straddle hops for three. Ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3.
One.
1, 2, 3.
Two.
1, 2, 3. Okay. Go ahead and sit down in your chair.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, great. Sitting down in the chair. So sit down in the chair, and what you'll do is you're going to extend, if you've not done this before, quick explanation. This is similar to setting the quads. So I will say, you know, extend, say, your left leg first. So you will fully extend the left leg and hold it in that posture, in that position for 15 seconds. And then there'll be a 3-second recovery. Same leg for another 15 seconds. We'll do each leg three times.
And when I lift it up, do I also try to squeeze the
Absolutely.
Muscle?
That's the whole point. So when you extend your leg, you're automatically, naturally going to contract your quadriceps. But just kind of focus on that. So really tighten it up. All right, here we go. Left leg first. Ready? And extend for 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and down for 3, 2, 1. Extend for 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Recover for 3, 2, 1. Last time, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we'll trade legs. Guess who's out there? Lewis!
Hey, Lewis!
Morning, Lewis. Pleasure. Good morning to you, sir. I sure am glad that you are able to be with us
Absolutely.
This morning. And you know what I mean by that. Okay. So Lewis is out there. All right, here we go. And John Jay from Jackson, Mississippi. Tennessee.
And he always takes his cute little dog out for a walk every
He does. Morning, Jay. Okay. Other leg now. Ready? And extend for 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover for 3, 2, 1. Extend for 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and recover for 3, 2, 1. Last time, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There we go. Okay, everybody up. And we don't need the chair anymore. That was
Wow. That
was our last. That was the only exercise we're going to be using the chair for. Well, I guess the two, the squats and the setting of the quads. All right, side straddle hops for three. Ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3.
One.
1, 2, 3.
Two.
1, 2, 3. Okay, dumbbells in your hands. We'll do some walking lunges. Ashley makes the dumbbells for the walking lunges optional for her. You may do the same or load it up. So in the space that you have, use that for the walking lunges. Ready? We're going to be on the clock for 1 minute. Ready? And go for 1 minute.
Sister Whitney that she sent to me and my little sister Casey. And so my sister and I'm sure many of you out there may drink Diet Coke or something like that. And she used to go and stop at a convenience store and she would get her fountain Diet Coke every morning before work. But since the pandemic, you no longer could do that. It had to be bottled. And this morning, her convenience store had them again, the first time in over a year, and sent us a photo of her fountain beverage. So excited. Sometimes it's just the little things,
for
That's
sure.
Right.
Speaking of little things, guess who's out there? Wiener dog! Okay, don't kill me for that one, Melissa. That was I just couldn't help myself.
Did you see what Emily tagged her in yesterday?
Yes, I did.
Oh, it's so great.
Okay, there we go. There's your 1 minute of walking lunges.
It
did go by fast. Side straddle hops for three. Ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3. 2.
1, 2, 3. Okay, on your mats, on your stomach.
Speaking of the little things, wiener dog is out there.
Speaking of the little things, guess who's out there? Wiener dog. Wiener dog.
I saw a little tiny wiener dog yesterday.
I tell you, they're just adorable.
Especially the little super tiny ones.
They're as adorable. They are as adorable as Melissa is.
I think Melissa's more adorable.
More adorable than a wiener dog? I can't really put up.
Alexa,
I really can't put up a good argument about that. I think you may be onto something. Okay. Melissa, we were talking yesterday, Ashley and I were about the convenience of your nickname when someone out and about says, aren't you a wiener dog? You know immediately how they know you. But now because of Facebook Live, the number of wiener dog fans is exploding exponentially.
And you also mentioned how you were so thankful that when you first called her wiener dog, that she took it in the way it was meant.
Right,
she wasn't offended.
I took a big chance by calling you wiener dog all those years ago, not knowing that you could have wheeled around on me and been more like a pit bull. See what I did there? Little dog joke. Okay, here we go. See what I did there? A little dog joke. See what I did again? Little dog joke. Oh, I'm just full of it for sure.
I was about to say you're full of it. You're full of it,
all right. Okay. All right. So we're going to do the first set of push-ups. And remember, in the down position, as Ashley is right now, and as you should be as well, when your hands are in the starting position for that, you automatically squeeze your shoulder blades together. We're calling that the squeeze. So maintain that squeeze throughout the repetition, throughout the range of motion. All right, here we go. Stand by. Push up, Marine Corps. Ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3.
1.
1, 2, 3.
2.
1, 2, 3.
3.
1, 2, 3.
4.
1, 2, 3.
5.
1, 2, 3.
6.
1, 2, 3.
7.
1, 2, 3. 8. 1, 2, 3.
9.
1, 2, 3.
10.
1, 2, 3.
11.
1, 2, 3. There we go. Don't go anywhere. Just flip over on your back. Flip over on your back and we'll crunch for 30 seconds. Any kind of crunching exercise that you want to do, you're on the clock, ready and go. For 30, 29, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right.
Woo!
Right back on your stomach. We're going to do another set of push-ups.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Second set of push-ups. Again, in the starting position, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Maintain that squeeze throughout the repetition. Here we go. Stand by. Push up. Marine Corps. Ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3.
1.
1, 2, 3. 2. 1, 2, 3.
8.
1, 2, 3.
9.
1, 2, 3.
10.
1, 2, 3.
11.
1, 2, 3. There we go. Don't go anywhere.
Woo.
Just flop right back over on your backs. Flop over, roll over. Let's do another 30 seconds of some sort of crunching exercise. Ready and go. For 30, 29, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right.
Ooh.
Yeah. Roll right back over on your stomach for your last last set of push-ups. You did. That was all out loud. All right, here we go. Stand by. Push up. Marine Corps. Four. Ready? Exercise. One, two, three.
One.
One, two, three.
Two.
One, two, three.
Three.
One, two, three.
Four.
One, two, three.
Five.
One, two, three.
Six.
One, two, three.
Seven.
One, two, three.
Eight.
One, two, three.
Nine.
One, two, three.
Ten.
One, two, three.
11.
One, two, three. All right.
I may have struggled a little with that.
I may have struggled a little bit myself. Whew. All right. Everybody up.
It's because I was trying to have good form. So.
You were perfect.
Thank you.
Said the man who's going to be
eating. You can see me while you're doing your own.
Said the man who's going to be eating food later on that you prepared. Catherine Speedling is out there. Hey, Catherine.
Good morning.
Hey.
Has anyone deciphered
Ashley's t-shirt? I bet you have. If you want to take a stab at it in the comments, there is no stupid response.
No.
And when I taught school, this is one of those things where teachers would say, oh, there's no such thing as a stupid question. The only people that would say that are people that have never taught school before. Because let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, there are a lot of stupid questions to be asked. So, all right, give yourself a little bit of room for some agilities. How about the two-step Heisman trophy drill?
I love it.
All right, for 30 seconds. Two-step Heisman, ready, and begin. For 30, 29, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, and apparently, your t-shirt has been deciphered.
Oh.
Yeah, Wiener Dog and Carol. Carol's awesome. Running in. Hey, Carol, good morning. I don't think I spoke to you specifically.
What did they say?
Pacifically. They said, check your colon.
That's right. You know, they actually recommend people start getting checked at 45, and a lot of insurances cover at 40, which is excellent. And I actually sort of had to fight because my doctor's office, I was having no signs or symptoms. So they really said, well, you should just wait to 50, but my insurance covered at 40. So I pushed him on that, and I'm glad I did, because I had 6 polyps, with a couple of them being larger. Luckily, they were all benign, so none of them had cancer, but now I go back in 5 years. But the reason I'm wearing this shirt is my good friend Bethany Smith, who's in her very early 40s, has colon cancer.
Yeah.
He's going through chemo and radiation, has had surgery, so you gotta get checked.
Yeah. I've had 2 colonoscopies. Tony, instead of talking to us about your dissertation, tell us more about your colonoscopy. Well, the first one is a bit of a funny story, I think.
Oh, that is a good one.
We'll try it out later. All right, let's move on, shall we?
You know, luckily, so here I am. I'm 49, and I had 6 polyps. And the last time you went,
that's right, zero.
The doctor did say that was one of the nicest colons he had ever seen.
I guess the second colonoscopy did have something comical happen. Yeah, the doctor. So he told me that I had one of the nicest colons he had ever seen. Yeah, that's right. And then he wanted to show me his calves.
And how'd you feel them, you remember?
That is true. So he was striking a pose. He pulled up his scrub trouser leg of his scrubs to show us his calves, and then insisted that I grab a hold of it. Ashley was starting to get a little jealous, and she said, oh, back up there, buddy. That's my man. That's my colon there. So,
because, you know, you never know, because people think when you're older, you're more likely to have it. But he had 0, and I had 6.
True. Okay, here we go. Side straddle hops for 3. Ready? Exercise. One, two, three.
One.
One, two, three.
Two.
One, two, three. Let's do a set of Swiss Army Knife. Okay, we're going to do three sets. So how about, how will you want to do the first set? 10 repetitions per?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll go with that.
So the first set of Swiss Army Knives would be 10 repetitions per exercise. So starting off with the hack squat, you'll want to, it's equal parts leaning forward, equal parts bending your knee. And then when you come all the way up, you'll want to come all the way up, straighten your body up. Let me move in the frame. Straighten your body up, and you'll want to roll your shoulders back slightly, and your hips come forward a little bit, and then you come. So that when you come up, it's like this. And you come down, and then you come back up, and it's like this.
Like you're trying to stand up and look like macho.
Like you're about to bow up on somebody.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
I've seen you do that.
You don't like
that.
That's right. I'll bow up on you. Okay. things I've never said until today. I'll bow up on you. Here we go. Starting in the down position for your hack squats. Ready? Exercise. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Five.
Five.
Six.
Six.
Seven.
Seven.
Eight.
Eight.
Niner.
Nine.
Ten.
Ten.
And now the rows. Be sure and keep your dumbbells should be parallel with the floor. So don't.
So it looks like you're trying to scratch up under your arms.
Or look like a monkey or King Kong.
Instead of doing it forward, which I would.
Exactly. Like. Here we go. Ready? Exercise. And one, two, three.
One.
One, two, three.
Two.
One, two, three.
Three.
One, woo! Two, three.
Four.
One, two, three.
Five.
One, two, three.
Six.
One, two, three.
Seven.
One, two, three.
Eight.
One, two, three.
Nine.
One, two, three. Okay. Okay, well, we're also double counting when we should be just doing single count. But for this first set, we'll do the double count for the other exercises
too.
You're not. Here we go. Bicep curls now. Ready? Exercise. And one, two, three.
One.
One, two, three,
two.
Two. One, two, three.
Three.
One, two, three.
Four.
One, two, three.
Five.
One, two, three.
Six.
One, two, three. One, two, three.
Eight.
One, two, three.
Nine.
One, two, three. Okay, that was. Here we go with the presses. Arnold press, overhead press, any kind of press. Ready? Exercise. One, two, three.
One.
One, two, three.
Two.
One, two, three. One, two, three.
Four.
One, two,
five.
Three.
Five.
One, two, three.
Six.
One, two, three.
Seven.
One, two, three.
Eight.
One, two, three.
Nine.
One, two, three. Now tricep extensions. I know. Ready. Exercise. One, two, three.
One.
One, two, three.
Two.
One, two, three.
Three.
One, two, three.
Four.
One, two, three.
Five.
One, two, three.
Six.
One, two, three.
Seven.
One, two, three.
Eight.
One, two, three.
Nine.
One, two, three.
Oh my goodness.
Okay. That was exciting.
It was horrible that I did it.
That was exciting. Okay.
I kept thinking, oh my gosh, something's wrong with me today.
Nope, it was just tough. Emily Malona Smith is out there. Maybe Aiden is too. Good morning, Em.
Are they still in Florida or on vacation?
Are you guys still in Florida? Or,
they had some great photos.
Yes. I like the pictures of Aiden having a meltdown because the load in his toy dump truck shifted and he lost his load, and I hate it when that happens.
Oh my God.
All right, here we go. Side straddle hops for three. Ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3.
1. 1, 2, 3. 2. 1.
2, 3. Okay. Here comes your second set. Tell you what, before we do our second set of Swiss Army knots, and it'll be different.
Good.
We'll do some balance work.
I love that.
All right. Plant the left leg. Bring the right leg straight up. Twist it around so that the right knee, your right knee is pointed down to the floor, and the sole of your right foot is facing up to the ceiling for 30, 29, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and now let's switch. Let's go the other way and twist it around. Same way for 30, 29, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Okay, now, Swiss Army knives. This time, just one repetition per exercise.
I think we should go with that. One. One repetition.
Now you're sounding like the count. One. Okay. One repetition. Okay.
I was afraid of him when I was a kid. I'd hide behind the couch.
Poor thing.
Well, he was scary. Look at his teeth.
Here we go. Here we go. Ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
8.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
9.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There we go.
Woo!
Put that down. Walked it off for a second.
I think it was more the count's maniacal laughter that scared me. I mean, who could laugh about numbers like that?
You mean that
yeah,
was...
I did not like that.
Okay. All right, let's do some two-step shuffle and touch for 30 seconds. Two-step shuffle and touch. Ready and go. For 30, 29, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Last exercise before we change gears to stretch. That'll be your Swiss Army knife. One repetition per exercise. A real one, not Tony's jacked up four count ones.
Okay.
Hack squats first.
Are we doing 10, though? I mean.
Yeah.
Okay.
Here we go. In the down position, ready, exercise. 1.
1.
2.
2.
3.
3.
4.
4.
5.
5.
6.
6.
7.
7.
8.
8.
Niner.
9.
10.
10.
Now the rows. Ready, exercise. 1.
1.
2.
2.
3.
3.
4.
4.
5.
5.
6.
6.
7.
7.
8.
8.
Niner.
9.
10. Bicep curls. Ready. Exercise. 1.
1.
2.
2.
3.
3.
4.
4.
Five.
Five.
Six.
Six.
Seven.
Seven.
Eight.
Eight.
Niner.
Nine.
10. Ready. Presses any kind. Ready. Exercise. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Five.
Five.
Six.
Six.
Seven.
Seven.
Eight.
Eight.
Niner.
Nine.
10. Tricep extensions. Exercise. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Five.
Five.
Six.
Six.
Seven.
Seven.
Eight.
Eight.
Niner.
Nine.
10. All right. You can put those down. You can put them away if you'd like. Okay.
I have to do side strong hops for three.
Would you like to?
Yes. To finish out that part.
Gotcha. Side straddle hops for three. You ready? Exercise. One, two, three.
One.
One, two, three.
Two.
One, two, three. And we'll change gears to do some stretching.
Yes.
Morning, Tonette. She said she was just stepping in to say howdy.
Good morning, Dee.
And she's celebrating Miss Willie's 98th birthday today.
Wow, how that's awesome. Awesome.
Okay, we'll change gears to do some stretching.
I think I told you my goal is to be Betty White.
That's a good goal. Yeah. Okay. This, if you don't have your shoes off, this would be a good time to slip those.
You have to tell me twice.
Good time to slip your shoes off. Okay. Now stand up straight. Roll your shoulders back. Breathe in deep and exhale slow. Now slowly start to float your arms up overhead. And then interlock your thumbs and stretch up. Stretch all the way up like you're trying to touch the ceiling if you're inside, or you're trying to touch the sky if you're outside. Now we're going to sway from side to side. Sway from side to side. It's not a fast sway. It's a slow and controlled sway. But each time that you do sway, try and sway just a little bit more. That may be the first sentence I've ever said that I use the word sway so many times.
Got the creaky floor over there. Make sure people know that's the floor, not your...
not my knees. Now sway all the way to the right. Sway all the way to the right. We'll hold that for 30, 29, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 20. 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly come back to the start. And now let's sway the other way. All the way the other way for 30, 29, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There we go. Take a big deep breath in and float your arms down to your side slowly. And then take a big deep breath in. Now we're going to go right into a back bend. If you need to put your hands in the small of your back for support, you may. Everyone will bend your knees slightly. If you can keep your arms up overhead, do that. So bring your arms up overhead or put your hands in the small of your back for support. Either way, we're on the clock now. We're going to start doing a back bend. Bend your knees slightly. Start to bend back at the waist. Look for the wall behind you or whatever might be behind you. And we'll do this for 1 minute. and then slowly start to come back to the starting position. And then you can take a big deep breath in and exhale slow and float your arms down to your side. And once your arms come to your side, we're going to go right into a forward fold. So start bending forward at the waist. Take your time getting all the way down. With every exhale, allow yourself to go down just a little bit more. And then slowly start to come back, standing up straight, come up slowly. And then stand up straight, roll your shoulders back, breathe in deep, and exhale slow. All right, from the front of your mat, we're gonna squat down, wrap our arms around our knees, and then we're gonna roll back for the cannonball roll. So do that, squat down, grab your knees, and then roll back. Then roll back and hold that position. Now keep your right knee into your chest, but fully extend and stretch your left leg and your left arm. Your left arm comes back behind you like you're trying to reach something that's just barely unreachable. And you're going to fully extend your left leg, pointing in the toes of your left foot. Now take your left hand, put it on your right knee. You're going to pull your right knee across your body and drop your right arm and right shoulder on the deck. Pull your right knee across your body and keep your right shoulder and your right arm on the deck. And just keep pulling with your left hand. Maintain the contact with the floor, with your mat, with the right arm and right shoulder. I'm glad we're doing it then.
Feels good.
And now let's switch and go the other way. So bring your left knee into your chest. Fully extend your left arm behind you, or your right arm behind you, and your right leg. So you're going to make the right side of your body as long as you possibly can. So stretch and extend. And now take your right hand, put it on your left knee, pull your left knee across your body, and drop your left arm and left shoulder on the deck as you pull your left knee across your body with your right hand. And then just keep pulling. Now if you pulled and you can't pull anymore, you can also then push down. You can push your left knee down toward the floor. And now you can release all of that and resume the dead man's pose, the relaxed pose, where you're just lying there. We're just here for just a second. Then float your arms up overhead, interlock your thumbs, take a big deep breath in, and exhale and do a sit-up. Touch your toes and flip over onto your stomach. Flip over onto your stomach and we're going to do a cobra stretch. Cobra stretch. Now, if you can't do that from your hands, you can do it from your elbows. We're doing it now. You want to stretch and look up to the ceiling or the sky if you're outside. And this is, as I've said before, this is one of those stretches where you really need to sort of concentrate and tell those muscles in your lower back and your glutes to relax. Now from here you can roll back into a good child's pose or lower back stretch. So keep your hands where they are, keep your hands planted where they are, but you're going to push your hips back, drop your head and shoulders down, push your hips back, but don't let your hands move. Keep your hands planted, drop your head and shoulders down, push your hips back, keep your hands planted. And then from here, we're going to roll all the way back. Put your elbows to your knees and sit back as much as you can. Make yourself as small as you can. This is another kind of cannonball. Now from here we can roll all the way back to a catcher stance. And then from there you can stand up straight. Roll your shoulders back, breathe in deep and exhale slow. I meant at the beginning to windmill our arms and do those things, so let's do that. So windmill your arms forward and back. Try not to knock anything down. Try not to knock a plant over. My wife has turned our house into Elvis Presley's jungle room. We're still, okay, now right arm across your chest. Right ankle flexibility stretches.
They're my babies. I don't have kids anymore, so I have plants.
That's good. Now let's go the other way. So left arm across your chest, and then left ankle flexibility stretches. And that's good. Now a little gentle twist side to side. Everybody likes the little gentle twists up from side to side. Some have even lobbied. Some have wanted a whole workout of nothing more than a gentle twist.
They'd be tired of that in 1 minute.
Oh yeah. It doesn't take long before this becomes burdensome. And then it doesn't take long for then it to activate small little muscles that don't get a whole lot of work. And the next day, you're unable to move or twist. Okay, let's change gears at this point. And we're going to go right into our 2 minutes of prayer and meditation. You can spend this time in any way that's profitable to you. Quiet time or intercessory prayer or active prayer. I'm sorry?
Outdoorsy prayer?
I suppose there might be. I don't know, but we'll discuss this later. I'll explain the subtle nuances of intercessory prayer to you. Okay, we'll take 2 minutes beginning now. And now you can come forward on your hands and flutter kick your legs behind you if you need to get some circulation back into your legs. And from there you can roll back to a catcher stance. And from the catcher stance you can stand up straight. Roll your shoulders back. Breathe in deep and exhale slow. And we are done, all done, everybody. All done. Turn to your neighbor and say,
excellent.
And say, way to go, good neighbor. Way to go, good neighbor.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if there's anyone I should say anything to. Remember, if you guys are watching and you want to have some
interaction with us, you'll have to say something. Otherwise, we'll just let you. Mickey is out there. Oh, how gozaimasu. Aww. Mickey's on. So I'm getting my second. First of all, good job, everybody. Good job. Way to go. Way to go. Good job. So today I'm getting my second vaccination, my second shot. If you have not gotten yours yet and you live in Memphis, today you can schedule. I don't know that anybody was getting turned away because they were too young or they were not infirm enough. I don't know of anybody that was turned away in the past, but certainly going forward from today in Memphis, if you are 16 and above, you can schedule for your vaccination. And please, even if you don't intend to be with me in person, please get your vaccination. Get that taken care of. Please don't listen to the idiots and the knuckleheads. I was going to say morons, but I think that would be an insult to morons who say no to the vaccination and the science. As a kid growing up, when I did, all of us had little scars on our arms from where we got the smallpox vaccination. Because when I was a little kid, little kids my age were dying of smallpox. Some were in iron lungs. I visited a little boy. He was the son of one of my mom's friends. And I remember going to the hospital and visiting him. And this boy was in an iron lung. If you don't know what that is, Google it and you'll know. So
reason that they don't is because people.
That's exactly right. The reason why you don't see any of that stuff anymore and why you don't see smallpox anymore is because the vaccinations work.
Yeah.
So people of my generation typically are not anti-vaxxers. We know from our own personal experience the great benefit of science that has rid us of polio and smallpox, and it's usually the younger folks out there.
And you know, one of the things that I've actually heard is people don't want to get it because they say they don't know what's in it. But I can tell you 70% of our immune system is in our gut, and we put Cheetos and tons of stuff in our bellies every single day that we really don't know. But actually, there's research showing it doesn't do our body good, and we're putting that stuff in there.
I don't really know what is in a moon pie, but I kind of like them.
Yeah.
So anyway, enough of that. Get your shots. That's where I was going with that. Don't forget your 1 hour of continuous cardio. What's our weather supposed to be like in Memphis? Do you know, over the weekend?
Tomorrow it's supposed to be rainy.
But as you
can see, you can get it in your
kitchen. It may be a soggy Saturday for some of us here in Memphis. So like and share this, and tell your friends, particularly tell your friends that are 40 and over and maybe haven't exercised in a while. That really is... people that are in their early 30s and are hitting the gym 15 times a week, that's not my target audience. That's not who I'm going after. I'm going after people that have hit sort of middle age, we'll say. Well, yeah. And I hate to admit this, but I guess I have no way of avoiding it. This year, my oldest son turns 40. Major Matthew Ludlow, United States Marine Corps, turns 40 this year. So my target audience is my oldest son's age and above. Well, I'll take anybody else that wants to participate. Trust me on that. It's just that the older you get, the more important exercise becomes. So that's who I'm really going after. The 20-year-olds that are hitting the gym 5 days a week, 6 days a week, every day, those 20-year-olds, they don't need this. They're bulletproof for now.
For a little bit.
Yeah. When I woke up on my, I think it was 26, I woke up and my body had mutinied. The day before, I could have eaten a whole dozen donuts and it never show up. The day after, I could drive by a donut shop and gain 10 pounds. So it happens to the best of us. Okay, enough rambling. Love you guys. We're planning to see you on Monday. Get your vaccinations. Be kind, be sweet, be loving. Just don't be a jerk. I was going to say another word that rhymes with Rick, but I'm... Rick! I have to tell the story of Rick!
And you forgot to tell your colon story.
Oh, man!
Aw.
Things to look forward to, y'all.
Tony's colon.
Tony's colonoscopy story.
So, Tony, I think I'd rather hear about your dissertation instead. Okay. Have a great weekend. Here comes the most embarrassing, potentially embarrassing part of our whole show. We'll see if Tony can click the little camera off without him looking like a moron. Ready, and...
You are...
Thank you for helping me do my job. You are dismissed!
Aye, sir!
Let's see what happens.